That's probably Dad, right? Making some excuse.
Yeah, no, I heard them fighting this morning.
Babe.
That's great.
His family and pay alimony still and the medical bills and
understood. All this.
Bet you didn't expect this much guy energy today.
I do think this is a record number of mothers for one patient. Okay, I want everybody to understand nobody's on trial here. I just want to get a sense of the family.
Until recently, Ellen lived with us.
She moved in with her father 18 months ago. Mm-hmm. We thought it might be good for her to heal that relationship. He's shown little interest in who Ellen really is. He's only interested in who he wants her to be.
Ellen is an artist. She's extremely bright and sensitive. She was never going to go into Chinese or computers or what have you.
Is that what you think your dad wants for you?
I don't know. Yes. I think he just wants me to be able to make a living.
Exactly. Is that a crime?
No crimes, remember?
The point is, Ellen's father never saw who she was. He left when she was very young.
Yeah, because you were sleeping with your best friend over there.
No, that's not why the marriage ended.
Oh, really? There's a better reason?
We are not here to defend our relationship.
When are you going to come up with a different narrative, Susan?
What really? Narrative?
What narrative, Susan?
No, this is the truth.
Jack didn't want to have sex.
Well, he likes it with me just fine, twice a week, like clockwork.
Oh, my God.
Besides, he's not the one who abandoned her.
We did not abandon Ellen. We moved to Phoenix.
They threw her out. They put her bags on the street.
Because we've been dealing with Ellen's illness alone for years.
I didn't abandon my daughter. I love her more than life. I just didn't know what to do. And she's dying right in front of us.
What's going on with you right now?
I'm sorry that I'm not a person anymore. I'm a problem. And it's all my fault.
Fuck fault. Fault and blame have no place here. Only how you want to live moving forward, who you want to be.